Welcome, everyone, to the campus of Puno School and the Hemner Fieldhouse for a game, interleague game between the Puno Buffin Blue and the Kamehameha Warriors. It's a girls' game, and it's a very pivotal game for the Puno Buffin Blue since they've strung together two great wins after some adversity with some injuries. And for Kamehameha, they're just trying to hold on to their top spot and stay sharp. This is a very tough season, and Puno just beat Iolani, and they also ended up beating Marino and Midpat, sorry. And those are two good wins with some injured girls. So I think Coach Robinson has figured out some of the things that she has to do. And I, watching their practices, they're a lot sharper, and they're on the same page. And so I expect them to come out really strong against the Warriors tonight, Shelly.
Yeah. Watching their practices, I know that they've been working on some really specific things that they needed to make adjustments with, and I think the girls are feeling pretty good about that. The coaching staff is feeling good, and so it'll be great to see how things have progressed.
Yeah, Coach Darryl Imanaka, he brings a seasoned crew with him, with Tia Konoa is kind of like the glue of their staff. They've always been pretty competitive, but I think she's the additive that has made them very successful this year. They had a close game up at Kamehameha last time, where Puno kind of took them down to the wire. However, I think tonight we might see the same thing, Shelly.
Yeah, I think you mentioned the addition of a couple of players on the Kapalama campus. Tori and Tiare. Tori's from Maui, KSK Maui, and Tia came from San Diego, La Jolla Country Day School. So they've got two new students on their campus and have been a great addition to the basketball program.
And here's our starting lineups for both teams.
Warriors,
number 10, Brianne
Nweku.
Number
10, Brianne Nweku. Number 23, Alohi
Robbins Hardy. Alohi Hardy. Robbins Hardy.
Number 25, Tia Konoa.
Tia Konoa.
Number
25. 32, Mia Mayo. Returnee.
And now, let's get the
now for the Buffin Blue. Buffin home
Blue.
Team.
At forward, a 5'11 freshman, number 23, Tyra Moy.
23, Tyra Moy, freshman.
At guard, a 5'8 sophomore, number 15, Asia Oliveri.
5'8 sophomore, Asia Oliveri, number 15. Number 13, Haley Moroka. Number 21, junior, Katie Waki.
Turner Wong.
Turner Wong, senior, leader of the team. We'll see how that goes. I mean, with Kanoa being a very seasoned point guard, we want to see how Turner can handle that pressure. And I know Kamehameha likes to get up tempo, and they'll pressure you all the way. So I think it'll be a good test for Puno. But I think with the home court advantage, that should give them some edge.
Watching Tia in the last game, I think she did in the beginning of her season, she's been very good about distributing and getting used to playing with her teammates. And I saw in the other scorecard that she scored 20, so I think she's finding her niche and finding spots for herself to get some points off. So this will be both teams have improved tremendously since the start of the game, so this will be another good battle tonight.
I think even from last year, Alohi looks a lot taller than she was last year. I think she grew. I mean, she was playing point forward. Jump. Puno controls the jump. Haley Moroko with the ball. To Tyra at the post. Skip to Katie Waki. Over to Turner Wong. Short corner to Asia Oliveri. Up and in. Nice transition for the jump ball, Puno. Puno with the ball. Puno in a half-court trap, trying to speed them up. They threw it over the top. Mayo with the hook shot, Moy with the rebound.
They've been working a lot on getting the ball into the post players. So we'll see how this works.
Morogo trying to figure out the man offense, and she goes right by them, and that's a good thing. Usually drive against pressure. So Puno up 4-0 really quickly.
Yeah, she didn't have anybody coming in, stepping in for help, so she took advantage of that situation.
Turner Wong channeling the ball to the left-hand side of the court. They go over the top, number 12 with a long three-pointer.
Kaya Ryder.
Turner Wong trying to set up the press break. Kamehameha 1-1-3. With all that height, they turn it over. Kanoa with the lay-in. They're putting their guards up front. Puno has to attack it. Get it to Moy in the middle. Ball over safely to Waki up at the top.
They had trouble breaking the press the last time, man. That looked a lot cleaner and a lot more settled. Oops.
A lot of pressure by Kanoa. Waki turns it over. Now Kamehameha on the run. Mayo goes up hard. Moy with the foul.
Tyra did a good job of preventing that ball from getting past her shoulders. So if anything, that was a good foul for us.
It's a good foul, but, you know, Shelly, we just saw Puno came up hot, two scores, and then within two possessions, now they're trailing by two.
Yeah.
Kamehameha has a lot of firepower on their side.
Lots of experience with Lilia.
Foul shot missed. Moy with the rebound. Wong bringing the ball up, trying to throw over the top to Waki. They're attacking. Waki with the dribble drive. Tipped out by Kanoa. Quick hands, quick feet. Kamehameha with a lot of pressure, trying to pressure the inbound. They get a hand on it and they steal it. Aloy Robbins with the ball. You call her a point center. Takes it right to the hole. Shoots over the top and followed by Haley Motooka. And Shelly with the addition of Kanoa. I mean, I remember last year, Alohi would play some guard.
Yeah.
And with Kanoa, securing that point guard spot, it kind of moves Alohi back to her natural position.
Right. It's she's been a really good addition to the team, I think in so many different ways. Alohi can, right there, showed us that she could take it to the hoop also, just like last year.
Into the game, yeah, for Puno, number 14, Astra Kidani, a freshman. She's a pretty good shooter, streak shooter, so we'll see what happens. Alohi hits that other shot. Puno down 7-4. Still trying to figure out their press. Ball skip back and forth. Morooka coming down the left-hand side. There's a trap. Hands on the ball, scramble. Moy picks it up. Skips it over to Kidani, backs to short corner. Oliveri, nice reverse layup.
Ooh.
And she gets it. She did a great job using the basket to shield from Lilia.
Seeing some great intensity by both teams.
Lilia with a three. Shows her range. Hustle play. Morooka with the ball. Scramble. Kanoa with the ball. Trying to set it up. See what Puno's in. A straight man. Looking into the post. Kanoa with a high pick and roll with Lilia. Goes to the basket. Nice jumper. Lilia with the offensive rebound. She slipped by Asia on that. Asia had a good box out. Just slipped by it. Ball off Haley's knee and back to Kamehameha.
Nice pass.
Great pass. Pretty good timeout by Courtney Robinson, because Puno just turned it over and Kanoa just came up the court and found Aloy Hardy right up the middle. We call that a rim run. I think Puno has done a decent job trying to get the ball past the front crew, but I think that's Kamehameha's plan, coach, is that, you know, you get it past their front littles and you get it past the half court and you can't go back, and then you got the bigs and the littles trapping and And like a good team, what Kamehameha is doing is, you know, once they get it turned over, they score.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. This is a part of the game that Punahou's needs to work on, is on that finishing. And when they make a steal or get the possession, really taking care of the ball.
In for Punahou, we got Sam Alakai, number 22, and Kel Ponofe, number 5, a little bit more length to the team. And now they're attacking with three bigs. And see how Kamehameha handles that. They go inside out with Asha Kidani, and she hits a three. Inside out, that kind of spot shooting can really help Pono spark them. Got Kiao Pono up at the top. They throw over the top, kitty corner, and Tyra Moyes in the back to gobble that up. I like Pono's strategy, putting Kiao up at the top. She's long and she's tall. Any deflection could be a steal for Pono. Ball inbounded to Kanoa. On the freshman, Kidani, who tips it away. She's reaching. She gets beaten. Jumper, three-pointer. Little short. Kiao Pono Fei with the secure rebound. Up to Turner. They're running to Sam Alakai. Pono sets it up.
We're seeing Sam back in the game again. She's been out for a few games with an injury, so this is her first time back.
They go high pick and roll with Moy inside. Sam comes out. I think she could have a mismatch. She's a little taller than the person she's guarding. Okay, ball back out to Turner, trying to reset. Dribbles left with a floater, draws a foul. In high school in Hawaii, we don't have the shot clock, so a lot of times if you are trapped up top, there's no urgency to shoot the ball, and I think Pono did a good job of not shooting quickly, and I thought that was a good move by the Buff and Blue.
They overplayed her on her right side. She took advantage of it going left, but they kind of pushed her out, and you know, she's playing with a little, she's not feeling 100%. But of course, Turner being the leader that she is and senior athlete, she's still going to compete. She's not going to sit and let this game get by her, so we're going to see maybe her taking a little bit of time and pacing herself a little bit.
Well, the score right now, Pono down by one. They've come back in the game with a three-point shot and some free throws. Kamehameha working the ball around. Pono, good help side defense. Long three-pointer. Another good rebound by Kiao Ponofe. Tipped out of bounds.
Again, like we mentioned in our last game, it's been nice to see. I mean, we've had a lot of new players on the court. Not too many returnees that have played as much. Got a couple of freshmen. Turner's been our most seasoned player, and it's just nice to see a lot of these girls getting some time and making it happen for themselves.
They go inside out again. Asia Oliver with a hustle offensive rebound. Puno's attacking over the top. They have some size and some good hustle, so they're going inside out also. High 1-4. They're trying to run a shuffle cut. Asha Kidani dribbling the middle. Pass to Alakai. In the corner to Kidani. Back to Alakai on the wing. Taking their time. I think Puno's doing a good job with the tempo. Turner with the jumper,
yes,
in the middle. Little short. Here comes Kamehameha. Kanoa bringing the ball down. Pono and a sagging man. Party with the ball up at the top. Gets to Lilia inside. Jump hook with the right hand. Nice move. There's no help side on that. And Hardy with her height can see right in there. Great post pass.
Great pass. Perfect. Exactly where she needed it.
Kidani brings it over. Kamehameha showing a different look. They didn't trap that. Straight man. Turner with the three from the wing. Little long rebound. Kanoa pushing the ball. Lilia was in front, and Turner tips the ball away. Katie walking for Turner. We got Pulani Apak. We have a mass substitution for Kamehameha. We got Tori Jean Cambra.
Chantel Alecki. Aaron Marks.
But you know who's still in there? It's Kanoa. They went into the post, and Kel Puno was guarding. I think she got a little intimidated. She shuffled her feet, traveled. Another turnover. Puno with another opportunity. And Puno has a lot of opportunity. You know, the game's only a three-point game. Ball bring up at the court. Walkie to Alakai, goes to the baseline. Jumper, a bit over. Apuk with the rebound. Pushing the ball up is Kanoa. Kanoa with the ball. To Aaron Marks. Shuffle cut, double shuffle cut. To number 14. Marks with the rebound. Good rebound, defensive rebound by Kel Ponofe. Push, Katie Waki pushing the ball. Find Astra on the wing. Takes it straight to the basket. Looked like she got the ball, but it was a hard take, and that sometimes that aggressive take will get you that foul.
Astra's got a lot of experience, intermediate play as well as club play, so she's not afraid to go hard to the basket, not intimidated. That Iolani game, she had 4 3-pointers.
Well, sometimes it's all that experience, but sometimes it's not having experience.
Yes.
You know, when you're a freshman, you don't know any better. Sometimes that's better.
Yep.
But you like that enthusiasm, you know. I think it helps the team one way or the other. Puno right back in it with these free throws. They're only down 1 point with a minute left in the quarter. Puno with some token pressure. And they get it to Aaron Marks, who's now playing the point as Coach Yamanaka chooses to rest his star point guard. Tia Kanoa. They're running a high post. A little pile up down at the bottom. Could have been kind of dangerous, but.
A lot of help side defense, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. But they ran that high post where there's no weak side, so there's an semi-isolation there. It's the second time she's traveled. I think the length of. Faye is intimidating, and she shuffled her feet. Okay, Puno with possession to take the lead. It's 13 to 12, Kamehameha. Kamehameha playing a straight man. Puno running their version, but they advise pass. They turn it over. Aaron Marsh with the semi-break. She turns it over. Waki with the ball. Scramble on the floor. Jump ball. Arrow to Kamehameha. Kamehameha has 19 seconds to do something with it. Haley Moroka in for Sam Alakai, who threw that run, maybe got some rust off her and kind of got back into the game. Running inside screen game. Number 33, a long shot, great box out. I think maybe Coach Yamanaka would want them to use a little bit more time. As Coach Robinson comes back with Turner Wong, another offensive threat. So I think Coach Robinson wants to take the last shot. Surprising that Kamehameha has a lot of faith in their outside shooting. You know, you see even their big shooting from the outside. Kidani bringing the ball up, going to the basket, kicks it back to Moroka, goes into Moy at the high post. Jumper, she hits it. Kamehameha pushes the ball, can't get the ball in. And Puno.
Nice. They did a great job of taking care of the ball there, to getting a good shot off. It was kind of a squeeze in that pass inside, but finished it.
You're definitely right, Coach. On that one, you know, it seemed like Kamehameha was dominating the game, but you look up at the scoreboard, now Puno's up by one, and it's because they've been very opportunistic in what they're doing. You know, they're kind of bending and not breaking on the defensive end and offensive side there, you know, manufacturing points.
You see a lot of great adjustments that Puno has made, so the substitutions seem to be a kind of key factor also in Puno. I mean, Kamehameha putting four people in at once, and then Puno is just kind of using some similar kind of substitutions, switching Asia out, putting Kao in. I know that they are using Kao with that second group to add another spark to the team and the flow of the game.
Yeah, but what a luxury Coach Robinson has with the size that she can bring in a KL with that length and with Sam and Asia. You know, I think that's awesome against a team that's athletic like Kamehameha. I think that's a very important. You can hear behind us the our famous Puno alumni band who's always here faithfully playing for the games, and that's highly appreciated.
Right.
Puno ball to open the second quarter. Waukee with the ball in the middle of the court. They're in a high 1-4 set. The dribbler through, and here's a pick for the picker. Faye inside, turnaround jumper, she hits it. Kind of hesitant, but then she found there's nobody by her, and she turned and she got a nice play. Great opening play by Coach Robinson. High pick and roll, Lilia gets it inside. Hardy on the perimeter, she takes a long three, just grazes the front of the rim. Scramble underneath the basket. Puno comes out with it. Moroka with the ball. Being hounded by Brand Nuweku. Back in the game, Turner Wong. Kamehameha is so sound in their defense. I'm very surprised that Coach Yamanaka is not picking these girls up full court.
Yeah. Might be saving that for second half.
They go double pick and roll, back up to Astro. Nice pick and roll to Kael Puno.
Okay, we haven't seen that before.
We haven't. I know they run a double pick, and they usually don't hit that person. I think Kael slipped to the basket, and great pass.
The practice has really been paying off.
Lilia with the ball up at the top with Hardy. They got two of their biggest girls up top. Moy with the deflection. They're trying to isolate Lilia on the post against Moy. Now Hardy comes out. Now Kanoa is to the right. Nuweko up at the top of the key, always got to honor her. They try to fake backdoor. Kidani with pressure on Nuweko.
She's a good shooter out there too, so I know they want to make sure they get a lot of, allow her to get the ball.
Moroka fouls Kanoa going to the basket. The key to that, if you watch the last couple possessions, Puno's done a great job funneling the ball through their left. Mm-hmm. And when they did that, their Kamehameha is not as effective. You got Kanoa driving to the right, which is her dominant hand. She comes up with a play like that, just manufacturing, willing her way. But Puno's doing a good job of switching off all their guards against her. But Kanoa, like a great point guard, hits two of her shots. Puno up by three. See what they run now.
Backed up there. Ooh, it's 1-3-1.
It's a trap because Hardy's up at the top. It's a 1-3-1 trap. And they throw it away. All that length up top, in the same sense how they use Kael Puno up at Puno's trap, they're using Alohi Hardy the same way, where it deters the ball reversal and you have to throw it down the side. Kanoa going back to her right again. Skips it to Aaron Marks. To Nuweko in the corner. Turner smells that out.
Almost took out the referee.
Chuck Martin almost goes down. Ball inside to Kael Puno. Oh. She misses. She gets her own rebound and gets fouled. She found herself a little under that basket there, but she recovered well and she's going to the line. Nice shot.
I think the team has been working on some free throws too. They know every possession is going to be really important.
Well, I'll say it, Shelly. Kiao's doing a great job this quarter. I mean, she has 5 points in this quarter. She's come out with 2 field goals and that, along with some good rebounding. Now Puno forcing left again. And I think this is their advantage, but they're coming back right. You got to always watch out for Nuweku. Lilia with the ball at the top of the key. It's a jumper. That's the shot you want her to take, but I remember last year she killed using that shot, that high post shot.
Changed the defense around.
Different
the
look. It was a straight man. Alakai to the basket. Jumper. A little bit long. Hardy with another rebound. To Kanoa. To Nuweku in the corner. Rim run with Lilia. Stopped by Moy, ball swung back out. Oh. I thought that was a walk there, coach.
Too quick.
But it was a good ball fake.
Yeah.
They're isolating.
Shooter.
With Lilia again, jumper, hits it. I see Tyra is, you know, she's kind of disappointed, but that's a shot you really wanted her to take. I mean, as long as she gets a hand up, and this, you got to give her credit. It's a good shot. Score tied 19-19. Hardy at the top. You know it's a 1-3-1 press. You throw in the middle. She had opportunity to get it, but it deflected. Hardy in the middle. Shoots it. Gets fouled. They had that press breakdown pretty good. It's just, you know, I think you know, we had some deflection there, but I mean, if not, there's an advantage, and I think that's one thing that they worked on in this weekend. I saw them with a really good press break. Alohi at the foul line with a chance to put the Warriors up. She misses the first one. I mean, she's been like a utility knife for this Kamehameha team, and she does everything well. She's on the top for the press. She rim runs. She runs the floor well. She got some rebounds, some assists. You know, I think other than Kanoa, I think she kind of solidifies the front line of their team.
She's so athletic. She can pick up loose balls. She'll receive bad passes and make something happen with it. So it's a great advantage to have her on the court.
Second shot, it's a little bit long. Moy chases down that rebound to Wong as Puno brings it up. Kamehameha again in there, half court man. Score still tied. Alohi missed two free throws. They run a pick for the screen. Ball's out to the corner. Trap. Out on Kamehameha, but Moy was stuck in that corner. And Kamehameha, when they trap, they are very aggressive. You know, which kind of, if you don't meet that aggressiveness, you might have some difficulty. Puno with the out of bounds play under the basket. Kamehameha going, man. Turner with the ball against Kanoa. Good matchup. Asia comes out. Now they're on 1-4. They're going to do a scissors cut right here. Here he goes. Right back to Kiao Pono. A little bit long. Lilia with the rebound. She went down. I think Koshi Yamanaka is kind of relieved she got back up, because I know we got some injured girls. I think Brianne's sister, Nueku, she's injured.
Right.
She had a knee problem, so we wish her the best. Hope she can come back.
I think I'm talking to coach. She's out for the season.
Okay. Well, hopefully she underclassmen. No.
Nope, senior.
So hopefully the best for her in a rehab, and maybe she can play at the next level. I saw her play. Right. She's a really good player. They're running a pipe cut with Marks. Two-man game. Lilia comes out. Oliveri on her. Hand up, box out. Grand Nueku tips it, keeps it alive, and Hardy with the rebound. So it's even important for little guys to box out. You're gonna high double screen right here. Have a pick and a seal. No seal there. Got Fia and Hardy, good matchup, good size there. Alakai dribbling the ball out. Trying to use her size against Kanoa. Misses, ball gets tipped around. Asia Oliveri with a great hustle play. Great rebound, she got hit on that elbow.
Asia's being in the right place at the right time. Gets a good shot in the middle of the key.
I like her effort. Asia is always a hustler, and you know that offensive rebounder. As a coach, you know that offensive rebound just kills you when you think you get it and somebody else does, and now that you foul and she gets shots and she finishes them like she does.
Another player, like you say, when sometimes it's good to know what you're getting into, sometimes it doesn't. She plays, she's young, she's still a young player, but she goes for it and is not afraid to mix it up with everybody.
Yeah, when it comes to players, anytime you can't fault effort, and that's one thing that, you know, I think Coach Robinson has worked with them with, go for it. Puno dropping back in a soft man-to-man, no pressure. Score still tied. Turner at the top of the key. They go high post to Lilia. Step back on Oliveri, who boxes out. Hit out by Hardy.
they're getting the ball into Lilia's hands a lot, which is a really positive thing for that team. I think she gets that shot. I think that's where she wants to get it and take that shot.
Puno with the same format, double high post, the screen, step out. They're looking inside to try to exploit someone. Kamehameha comes out, throws over the top. A little too long. Kamehameha coming down in transition. Puno with the ball. Goes to the corner. It's a post up. Apak kicks it out.
Nope.
Ball fake, go back to Apak. We're going to call that an offense. She led with her elbow. And Asia with a great position.
A tough player, you know. She's got a good heart. She plays hard all the time. I've seen her in the preseason games, and good sportsman, tries her best, and sometimes her feet are moving before her body are, but other than that, she plays hard. And
high post isolation, Turner with a jumper. Somebody in her face. Now they got numbers. Marks with the run. And get it. Faye with another rebound. Stuck at 21 with a minute half left. And, you know, somebody's trying to get an advantage here. Both, you know, pretty good offense, but better defense right now by both teams. Trying to run a cut. Scissors cut. Somebody goes back door. There's doubling. Walkie with an edge. Finds Faye. Jumper, a little bit long. Oliveri in there, hustling, keeps it alive. Marks with the ball, bringing it up to Kanoa, right hand, pulls up, pops, hits it. I think she's done that before.
Yes. She plays a lot of club ball in San Diego with her San Diego team. They travel a lot. She's got a lot of experience.
Puno going 1-4, pick for the picker. High post with a screen. You got a mismatch inside. You know, that's one thing I'm pretty sure Coach Robinson should be talking about in halftime is finding Miss Kanoa in the transition game.
Right.
Either jamming her or have somebody just be the rover on her. I think she's the little engine that makes everything run. If you stop her, then maybe you have a chance. And
right.
And Coach Yamanaka chooses to rest her right now. Got high-low, Moy stepping in. Faye with the ball, Puno's intent to take a good shot. High pick and roll with Wong and Moy. She sends her back down. They're gonna go low 1-4. Having Turner having one-on-one on number 20 here, Aaron Marks. Now they switch off, you got Hardy on there. There's a mismatch. Moy on Marks. She goes up
and
she finishes it. A great recognition by Turner and great post pass by Motooka. You know, post passing is a lost art. A lot of times you see her there, can't get in there, but great pass. She got her right into her sweet spot. Tyra turned on the littler one and exploited that, and somebody came over and fouled her. So chance for Puno to take the lead at halftime.
Great job in finishing that shot too from our freshman.
Well, she misses, but, you know, Kamehameha is going to bring it down. Here comes Marks. Bring it up left-hand side of the court. See what they set up. Tori Jean Canberra going to the right. She's blocked. There's Motooka. They're running. 7 seconds. They have numbers. Goes cross. Faye scores. What a great pass. What a great pass by Haley Motooka. You know,
that's got to be a nice feeling going to the halftime.
Well, you're up two, and you know, like I said, you got little spurts here and there with your daughter, Kiao Pono, came out in the third, you know, second quarter with a run. And that last one, you got Motooka making a great post pass, and then now she's running the court, and she knows where Kiao is going to be, and she eyes Turner. Everybody's looking there, and she skips it across. And for halftime entertainment, we have our dance team, our Puno dance team. And, you know, they've worked hard at their craft. And Miss Miley Rakuya alum is in charge of them. And she does such a great job with them. And they've worked different games. And they, you know, they have the commitment to come out to our games. And, you know, like basketball, I see some little guys out here and some older guys. So here's our dance team. Thank you.
reaction.
Washington, D.C. now for the inauguration, but when we got the alumni band and the dance team, you know, they put in a lot of time themselves, and like athletes, you know, they should be viewed as athletes. And there's just some of the moves out there. I think I might have to go to chiropractor just watching those moves. My body's sore just watching that. But great job. And, you know, at halftime here, we are in a close game like we kind of imagined, and Puno up by two. Some great stuff going on, and following this game we got the boys game, and that should be a pivotal game where, you know, Kameme has lost some games and Puno is kind of on a run, and
this will be their first meeting.
Yeah.
So yeah. We got a lot nice crowd coming in to watch these games. It's great to have these back-to-back games. Really appreciative of that for parents as well as the students and fans. So.
Yeah, you got a son and a daughter, so you just got to pay once, right?
They planned that.
I think so. That's really good. But, you know, if you really think about it as a whole, it's good because then you get appreciation, and it brings families together, and it also brings, like, old classmates together where,
right.
You know, you say, I didn't know they were playing basketball. I didn't know he was playing basketball and things like that.
Right.
So I think it's good for the school, and I think we have a couple more like that. I think next week, Saturday... Puno plays Iolani girls here.
Right.
And I think Puno boys play Marino.
Marino, big
so
game.
Two big games, you know.
Right.
So, and that one will be also a webcast. So I think that's super key for you know, the Puno webcast and Yuri and his gang. I think we don't talk about it a lot, but, you know, these webcasts are super important, not only as archiving memories for the athletes involved, but also for, you know, coaches who may want to, you know, recruit some girls, or you can do things like that. You know, parents.
And alumni.
Alumni, and, you know, sometimes opposing coaches too, yeah.
Right.
But I think, you know, Puno does a good job of doing that, and it's not only service to the initial Puno community, but also for the whole community in general, because these webcasts are also posted on YouTube, so even the girls from Kamehameha, they can, you know, also view them and maybe download them as an archive for themselves. So,
yeah,
I think that's very important. Coach, what do you think the keys? What do you think Coach Yamanaka said in his little brief meeting with his girls?
I'm sure that he's going to be talking about, or he's talked about some of the adjustments and the things that Punahou is doing right now is very different from what they showed last time. They're showing a lot of more versatility. They're passing the ball inside a lot more. The bigs are getting more active. It's more purposeful rather than grabbing a lot of loose balls. It's very purposeful, and they're going to have to stop that and prevent that inside game.
Yeah, you know, I think, you know, although this is the second round meeting for both teams, you know, a lot of adjustments have been made, and a lot of development, you said, has been made on the Puno side of the ball. And I think maybe for Puno, they should be exploiting the same type of thing. I think Puno utilized their bench. Got great contributions off their bench. and they've gone kind of deep through it. You know, they played eight. Kameme has yet to utilize, you know, they've utilized their bench, but they haven't gotten any spark off their bench. And I think, you know,
I think that's what he's trying to do too, is get them some time and maybe give them some confidence so that they, when they do go get on the court and when it counts, that they'll be able to support the starting group.
I think Pono, you know, I think they understand that it's a synergy thing and everybody does their little part, whether it's bringing up the ball, setting a screen, making a parlay up. I think those types of things are going to add up to what we see right now with the score being 25-23. Kameme is doing some great things, but it doesn't seem like it's in the game situation. It's, you know, run out here, ISO there. But Puno has shown, if you view a lot of their plays, they're a lot of teamwork-oriented plays where a screen is set, a cut is made, a pick and roll. They're finding things, and like I said, I like their aggressiveness on offense and defense, and that's manufacturing some points. And a lot of times everybody knocks the officiating because, you know, a lot of times they feel that they're involved, but, you know, they, other than Chuck Martin almost piling on the sideline, you don't notice them, and that means they're doing their job. I mean,
right. The
game's pretty, you know, running smoothly, and the calls are they're made, and it seems pretty even, and everything is good.
I think there are teams that come out and press and double team and create a lot of havoc, and that creates a lot of challenges for referees to make some of those calls. But maybe that's what's going to happen this time around. Maybe their teams are going to be coming out and creating a little bit more havoc. They've been pretty civil, and I know that both teams really respect each other. They know each other. They've been playing with each other in club as well as against each other since they were an intermediate. So,
yeah, Coach, I totally agree. I'm sure that Coach Yamanaka is not going to sit back in and, you know, just sit back at half court. I think he might extend it. We saw his 1-1-2-1, three-quarter press, and we saw their 1-3-1 half-court press. I have a feeling he's going to put a little more pressure on the Puno guards. And and if you remember in the beginning of the game, Puno did turn the ball over a couple times, and that's why Kameme went up with, maybe a four-point lead. And then when you don't score, then you can't press. They went to a drought there. Kameme went to a drought where they didn't score, and Puno inched their way back. But it's been a well-played and a well-coached and a well-official game thus far, and we're looking forward to more in the second half. We got about a minute left before the second half tip-off. But great contribution, like we said, from Puno's bench, and nice leadership by Kamehameha with exploiting their go-tos with Tia Kanoa and Lilia and Hardy just being around the basket and being a threat offensively and defensively.
I think we're seeing some great basketball, girls basketball. We're seeing great plays, and it's a nice thing that as the crowd for the boys' game starts to arrive, that they come in and they start to appreciate what the girls are doing out here on the court. And I'm sure that some of the girls' parents and families will be staying for the next game to support the boys' teams also.
Okay, starting for Kamehameha, we got number 25, Kanoa, number 12, Ryder, Brianne Nweku, number 10, Lilia, number 32, and Alohi Robbins Hardy. And it'll be Kamehameha's ball to open the second half. Starting for Puno will be number 20, Turner Wong, number 21, Katie Waki, number 13, Haley Moroka, 23, Tyra Moy, and number 15, Asia Oliveri. Puno coming out with a half court. Kanoa fakes going over the high post. Back to Hardy up at the top. Looking for an ISO. Pick and handoff. Nothing. Lily at the top to Nweku. On the left-hand side, looking for a two-man game, maybe with Hardy waving over a high screen. Nweku uses that screen, going to the middle. Dribble handoff with Kanoa going to her left. Back to Lilia with a half hook shot. Great rebound. Moy does not box out. Got the ball taken from her. Hardy in her length.
There
I think Tyra did a good job doing that, but Puno turns it over. The same
You called
same
that,
press,
Alan.
Yeah.
They stretched it out a little bit, went full court.
There's a mismatch inside with Hardy. Somebody's loose, sure. Wide open. It's Marks on the weak side, and she gets... It's Ryder on the weak side. I think Turner got mixed up with Hardy, and they're two on one. Pono struggling to break the press. It's a 2-on-1. They try to go over the top. It's tipped by Lilia. Great opportunity to score there. Hardy with a rim run. Find Lilia at the top of the circle. Konoa wide open for a three. She misses. Doesn't hit anything. Turner with the rebound. Picks up the ball in the backcourt. Trap. Waki bringing up the middle. They have numbers if they have it. Moy in the middle. Turn. Turn on jumper. Misses. Follows her own. Hardy with the rebound. A piece is up in Nueko at the baseline. Goes baseline. Not Aaron Marks. Keolani Ryder to Nueko in the corner. Dribble over Lilia. Hand off to Kanoa. And they're forcing her left, making you use that screen. She pulls up. Hits the jumper. There has to be a hedge to that screen, Coach, yeah?
Right. They know it's coming, and it's a matter of...
Foul on Kanoa, on Turner. Pono's dribbling through that press. Yeah. I think they'd be better off if they use short, quick passes. And when they did that, they'll do a better job. We got Kel Pono Faye coming in for Tyra Moy.
I think they're having a hard time seeing the court while they're seeing their players open, but the defenders in front of them and are not passing that ball around the defense. So
your high pick and roll.
Makes a hard
Turner,
shot.
Turner, tough shot. The girl's right in her face. Ryder's right in her face. Here comes Kanoa running the court. No numbers. Moroka runs her down and tips the ball away. 1-on-1. Lilia versus Wong. Wong pulls up for the jumper. She misses. Now here's Tomemea. Nueku goes by her. Goes up. Kind of a two-hand scoop shot. She misses, but there's a foul called underneath. I didn't see that foul on Oliveri.
Missed it.
The pace of the game has quickened.
Definitely, yes.
With Kameme up four, coming out of the third quarter really hard. Kanoya in the high pick and roll screen, pulls back for a three, off the front of the rim. Ryder with the rebound. She's Johnny on the spot. Go high post with Lilia and Kanoa. She goes baseline. The hedge is there. Ryder exploiting the key. Nice layup. Right across the basket with her right hand.
I think we're going to be in a timeout pretty soon.
I would think so. They throw it over the top to Oliveri. She hits it. They needed that to stop the run. Yeah, and even definitely. That shot could have been easier if she took in a par layup. But they did exactly what they should do. They have to beat the press for layup so they don't press anymore. Kind of lull in the action. Guys are walking, maybe catching their breath.
Kamehameha is just trying to make sure that they make some good passes, take care of the ball.
Motoko forcing over the screen. There's still no hedge. She goes behind. Robin steps out for a long two. Ball is rebounded. Motoko, they have numbers. Pushes up. Waki in front. Takes a right-hand hook shot, and she gets a layup. Second time we saw that where Motoko gets a rebound and pushes it herself. That's a luxury of having a couple good ball handlers on the court.
All right, so here
Kanoa exploits the lane again. Faye with the
we've got potential block. Scoring on transition.
Pono's rim running. Okay, Al Pono came in and disrupted that shot, and she got the layup. Now Pono's on their run.
I think it was a nice job by Asia to use that bounce pass. We've been trying to go over the top and
Pono forcing left again, which is a good thing. Motooka pounding Kanoa, who looks very tired. Ryder now taking the top of the point, dribbles it through. Here comes Kanoa coming up at the top. Moroka's right on her. There's no hedge on the top. She's going to shoot a jumper, and she's a short. Kiao with another rebound. They're running. Kameme is tired. But that was not a good pass. And now Pono comes back. Turner Wong with a hustle play. I mean, Pono Puno was tired, but I think they had numbers. They had like a 5-on-3. And that's why it's important to run in lanes, coach, right?
Right.
I mean, Kiao was rim running, but you do not hit the five
right.
at the 3-point line unless he's going to dunk it.
Right. Yeah, it would have been a nice thing to have it on the wing, from the wing to the post.
Definitely. Yeah. But, you know, you like the pushing because you see a lot of people holding, you know, hands on hips and things like that.
Right. She was hesitant. She wasn't quite sure whether that fast break was going to happen. And, you know, got to give her credit for having trust in her teammates to go for it. So
in for Puno is Asha Kidani, number 14. Kamehameha substitutes with number 14, Tori Jean Canberra, and number 33, Chantel Alecki. Walkie with the ball. She's pushing. She's looking to push.
Slow down.
Do a dribble weave at the top. Everybody's getting involved in the dribble weave. And
making some not such good choices.
And Asia throws it away. But that's, you know, I don't think that's really her fault, because I don't think coach wanted her involved in the three-man weave. You got your three guards with Wong, Walkie, and Kidani.
Go ahead.
Yeah, your post would stay down and you read with those three.
Right. And I think what you're seeing is a lot of ball control by Kamehameha. And there's a little bit of panic in that last series with Punahou. So I think that's one thing they're going to need to do is just kind of take care of the
four.
Ball.
Yeah, another turnover. But I think this one's going to Punahou. Well, I think, you know, maybe they still have that thing stuck in their mind, because I think they played a pretty good game up at Kamehameha and they still came out on that short side of the stick. So I think they're thinking that they might need a lead to sustain it. You swing the ball around. Looks like a nice front cut by Moy. She's wide open. They got to give her the ball. And they can't get the ball to the wing, and now it's a 2-on-1. Yeah. Good defense, and they scramble. Moy with the ball to Kidani, freshman on freshman. Oh, good move by Astra. Just didn't control it. Both teams playing up tempo. A lot of tips on the ball. Nweku with the three. Good tip. We got a rebound again. Are they going to run? Coach encourages them to run. Kidani in the corner. They're running a low 1-4 or high 1-4. Scissors cut. Here it comes. We have a blocking foul. Because of the Puno spacing on that scissors cut, it takes a little too long with Astro so far away. You got to make that first cut. Kind of leaves Kiao out too dry holding the ball.
They're not balanced on the court, too. They're kind of all bunched up at the free throw line. So
we got some good, you know, equally... We got some equal size out there, so it's good matchups. We'll do a pick for a picker here. Screen for the big. Dribble through. Here it comes. Looking at Moy. Get her the ball. And that, like I said, that's an art, getting her the ball. Faye with the re-steal. Aloy Robbins with the re-steal. Now she's bringing it up as the point center, and she scores.
Nice finish.
I mean, that's what we're talking about, point center. Puno a little tired. Kidani at the point now. Dribbles her through. Waiting for it. Goes all the way. Gets fouled.
I don't think Kia wanted to allow her in there, so got her hand on the ball, but got a little bit more than that, too.
I mean, you're always taught as a player, when you're pressured, you dribble pressure, and I think Asha did a good job about that. And it gives Puno time to regroup. You know, not using a timeout. Coach Robinson chose not to use a timeout. This is a good time to have the girls rest as she barks out information from her bench.
This game is a little reflective of that Division II game we just saw right before this. Punahou Division II versus St. Francis. Score went back and forth.
It makes good for webcasting, right?
Yeah.
All right. Here we go, Kanoa coming down the left-hand side. I mean, they're giving her the left-hand side. Moroka's playing, forcing her baseline into Kiao Puno. She comes back into the middle. Lilia from right inside the three-point line, a little bit short. Scramble on the floor. Jump ball. Good hustle by Puno, and now they're rewarded with the possession.
Got 35 seconds left in this quarter. We'll see what they do with this.
Oh, they're coming out with a 1-3-1 half-court trap. They're going to try to turn her over.
We
got to get over.
We use our passing. Do we use our passing?
And they turn it over. Engaging the trap is important, but knowing where to pass after that is even more important. So Kamehameha with an opportunity with 21 seconds left to extend their lead. Nueka with the ball. It's a spot throw in. Puno with some mock pressure. There you got a trap here. Puno with their own trap. Ball goes inside. Robbins with the ball. Gets an offensive rebound and puts it up. Just a very savvy and heady play.
Yes.
You know?
Just waited. She was very patient.
The key is that, you know, some of the things that she possesses is like intangibles, you know?
Right.
You can't teach that. She's just right there. Great anticipation.
Court
probably
sense.
Comes from her volleyball background to where you think the ball is going to be and things like that of that nature. She hits a free throw. And I remember in the first half she missed two straight. And now she hits a second one. She looks like she's in a groove. Puno down by three.
They're going full court. Eight seconds to go.
Got to get the ball in.
Nobody touched the ball, so the ball's under the basket.
It's a very tough one because, you know, she did make it, so Astra could run the sideline. Mm-hmm. And she's throwing pass cross court through the basket, which is a very dangerous pass. And now you give Kamehameha a second chance. But they turn it over. Kiao with the ball, 4 seconds left. Moroko with the three. Looks like Astra's going to bank that in from our distance.
Yeah.
Well, Kamehameha comes out, you know, they come out and answer in that third quarter. They were trailing by two, and now they're up by three. They won the half by 5 points. But the good news for Puno, you look at Kamehameha's shots, they're all short. So you know that maybe they're up-tempo, that Puno was playing in that little scramble that they had in the beginning is making Kamehameha's legs a little weaker, and they're short on everything. But like Kamehameha did in that first quarter, they turned Puno over, and they made it difficult for them. So Puno still, their answer is still, they got to add to that pressure, and they got to play, they got to play to win, I think. You know, they got to play in a way where they're going to attack and score.
Puno players got to know where they should be, where they need to be, and not just run a play. They need to create some options and maybe be a little bit more patient on the passes and giving their teammates some time to get to their positions and making the moves. I don't know if there's some miscommunication out there. Sometimes we seem to force the ball in and it's not there. And defensively, Kamehameha is doing a great job of having their hands in the lanes and making it difficult, especially over the top.
Well, you got to credit Kamehameha for that and Coach Darryl Yamanaka because he has Alohi Robbins Hardy up at the top when he went into that 1-3-1 and it forces a up-tempo type of game that Puno's not ready to play right now. Kamehameha, a straight man. Puno goes to UCLA cut. Here's the double screen coming. That's a slip that we saw in the first half. Kiao Puno goes to the basket. A little bit off on the bank shot, but it was open. Kamehameha running. Kidani with the deflection. Secured by Moy. A lot of contact. No call. Great hustle by Lilia. She didn't save the ball, but she hustled in. As a coach and as a fan, you got to appreciate that effort.
Right.
You got to applaud that effort.
Nice tip on defense also on that long pass to create that loose ball.
Okay, Puno needs an answer. They're down three. Going to run that same thing with a slip and a screen. See what they do with it. He's open on that side. Kidani with a shot. A little bit off. Free throw jumper. Here comes Kanoa. Puno has to run back and watch where the ball is. Ball coming down the left-hand side. High screen by Lilia. Kanoa in the lane. Her hand got hit. Robbins on the other side. Great assist. And Robbins just camping on that side.
Capuano coming over to help and not being able to get back and play, or right. someone not rotating.
We need that last rotation.
Yeah.
They go high. They're going to do the same thing. Maybe they saw something. You need that screen.
It's sort of a blindside pass that they're doing once they cut across that screen. That's kind of a tough one.
Well, that one was, Asher threw it toward the roller.
Yeah.
But what usually that, the Utah Jazz used to use that in Old Dominion Stockton, mm-hmm. where instead of throwing to the roller, you throw it to the wing, because that means the defender was on the high side.
Right.
When the ball goes to the wing, now you got inside position on the inside. But, Asher being young, that'll come. Kialpono on the watching Robbins on the perimeter. Great pass. Oh, Ryder, offensive rebound.
We got an elbow or something in the face, in the eye. She's okay, shaking it off.
With Robbins Hardy out on the perimeter, seeing over that defense, she makes a lot of great passes. They're running a three here. There she is. She's open. Got to give her the ball. Tyra wants to make a move. She misses. Stolen by Morooka. Great hustle. Moy on the spot. She hits it. Great job by Morooka.
She does a great job of anticipating and making those steals on an outlet pass.
Kanoa coming down. Setting the tempo. Comes around that high screen again. Crossover. Jumper in the middle. Cannot stop that. Yep. Basically, Kaylee played some great defense. That was a shot that she hit. Mimi distancing herself a bit. Turner drives in, misses. And there she is again. Kanoa with the ball coming down the left. She's going to get a high screen right here from Lilia. She pulls up for the three. That would have been the dagger. Kialpono with another rebound. Guards have to come back and help the ball. High 1-4. Here it comes. Double screen. What are they going to do with it? Turn the corner. Waki misses the layup. Moy with a good hustle. Faye with the rebound. Goes up. Looks like she got hit. Nothing. Leah with the rebound. And Kamehame has numbers if they want it. Nweku in the corner. Tipped away by Moy. Asha Kidani in for Puno along with Asia Oliveri. With 6 minutes in the quarter, this is a very pivotal time for both teams. Because Kamehame can get some edge here and Puno can get a little closer. Gotta make use of their possessions. They're precious. What is Puno in? They're in a 1-4. New point guard. Gotta create a lead. Here he comes. Still dribbling. Here it is. A little dribble handoff. Morooka goes in. Skips it over cross. Back to Morooka in the middle.
Short.
For three. Little short. Robbins with the rebound. Kanoa with the ball. Coach Daryl Yamanaka calls a timeout. Maybe he settled on his girls, or maybe set up something, or maybe take some clock. Take some air out of the sails and maybe burn some clock and make Puno chase a bit.
Right.
The foul totals are 3 for Puno, 4 for Kamehameha. So Puno wants to get that ball back. They got to foul a couple times to get in that 1-on-1. Those are a lot of things that the coaches got to think about. And that's why both staffs have a lot of assistance. Hopefully they're whispering in their coaches' ear. These things, that's so important, having these assistants. Not only having them in practice, but just a little reminder here and there for what we're looking at, who has so many fouls, things like that.
Right, and utilizing the substitutes too as far as the fouling goes.
Kehlani Ryder inbound to Kanoa, bringing the ball up. Maybe have a set play here. The front cut with Nweku, and here it comes. She goes baseline, tries a finger roll, and Kialpono with a great block. Some great help there.
I'm wondering if that was an intended shot there.
It looks like a shot.
Yeah.
Finger roll.
Yeah.
Here it comes. What are they doing? Lily out on the perimeter. Back to Kanoa. They're forcing her left. And they're clearing the side, too. They cleared the side for her. Lilia with a shot. Little short here. Kel Ponofe with another rebound. She's going to bring it up. Get it to a guard. Idani bring it down. Right hand behind the back. Going to the basket. She's in the. She's with three. She turned it over. Kanoa coming back. Over. Oh, nice. Nice over. Kehlani Ryder with a up and over for a 7-point lead.
Just as I was thinking about where Turner was, here she is on the substitute bench.
Nice screen for the big. They ran the screen for the big where they go high post entry and the other screen, other post comes in screen. And they exploited the Kamehameha bigs that time, and Asia got loose for a little baby hook, which she was fouled on. First shot is good by Asia Oliveri.
Much needed.
Turner Wong in for Katie Waki and Tyra Moy in for Kael Ponofe. Pono has to be thinking about what they're going to do to up the tempo. 3 minutes left, trailing by six, now five. And Pono calls a 30. Maybe they're discussing, oh, now they're changing it to a four. Maybe they're discussing what they're going to do.
I think she had one of the strategies was to give Turner a bit of a rest, and she's going to have to play the rest of this game, and knowing that she's not really 100% right now, this is her. That was her rest as an opportunity for her to turn it on and lead her team.
And my coach, you and I know it's not about the offense. Not
yeah.
about the offense.
Yeah.
Because if they trade, Kamehameha is going to end up winning by five. Puno needs to get a stop.
Yeah.
And then also a conversion on their stop. So, you know,
right.
if you can play back and forth, Puno will end up on the short end. So Puno needs a stop somewhere along the way. They can go 3-for-2 if they feel that they want to depend on the three-point shooting. But at this point of the game and
right.
you know how much they've ran, I wouldn't think the three-point shot is their key right now, especially with Kamehameha playing a man-to-man defense.
Right, right. And when they do get those turnovers or going to the basket, they just got to finish.
Yeah.
They got to finish.
Well, if there's any time Puno has to be opportunistic, it's in his last 3 minutes.
Right.
Baskets here or there, little tips here or there. They need to get in the game and turn the ball over. Force Kamehameha to turn the ball over. And they look like they're doing something here. And Kamehameha is in a press break. And Coach Yamanaka thought about it. High entry to Alohi Robbins, and she might bring it up. Kanoa comes back and gets the ball, so Puno wasn't in anything. Oh, they are in something. They're trapping from behind.
Right.
And they're setting up. Somebody turns their back. Maybe they'll trap. Nueku trying to post up Hidani. They got high post on Lilia.
Haley doing her best to deny that ball to Kanoa, but Kanoa is just too quick. And
you got Hardy out here with Chuck Martin counting. She almost got the five. She put it on the floor. Kanoa's wild. She's dribbling wild out there. Hardy back in, a little bit short. And it's Puno ball. She was really close. I thought she was gonna, she's gonna lay it in. Maybe that's one of the stops they need, but I think they are lucky on down because she was right at the front of the rim. Commitment straight man. Puno, high post entry, the screen on the ball. Scrum on the floor. Moy with the ball, and it's gonna be Kamehameha ball.
You think a little bit too much dribbling in that key area?
Well, I think the play is really good, but Tyra has to roll faster.
Yeah.
I don't think she rolled faster, she'd be wide open.
Yeah.
And that's something they just put in this week, and I don't think they're really comfortable with that, especially with the bigs handling the ball. Robbins out front taking Moy. She gets a seam, and she beats her. And that's the versatility we talked about,
right.
you know, her playing at a guard position all last year, and now suddenly... She's got Tyra Moy, a freshman, out in space.
They're going straight man to man, and there was absolutely no help down there, so they took advantage of that one-on-one situation.
And she hits her free throws. Kehlani Ryder coming out. Tori Camera coming in. See what Puno does. I mean, that mismatch will always be. And Hardy with another free throw, Robbins Hardy. And somebody's gonna have to guard her on the offensive. They gotta figure out something. Turner trying to exploit. Kano up top, can't get by her, trying to put her head down. And Lilia with the ball. Now Hardy's up in space. She's gonna take it all the way. Her size. Nope, no call. Moy coming back in, fouling. Kanoa, not only is she a good offensive player, she's a decent defensive player. I know Turner's a little bit under the weather, but she's keeping Turner in front of her and making her take some tough shots. Tori Jean Camera at the line, and she hits her shot. Good timeout by Coach Robinson. Got to figure out something. Maybe sub offense defense, because you have the issue with Alohi taking Tyra out on the perimeter.
Right.
Maybe do something of that, or coach, or maybe on this offense end, maybe put some 3-point shooters in to see if Robbins chases and Leah can guard on the perimeter or something like that, and maybe foul.
You've got 3 3-point shooters. You've got Haley, Motooka, and Turner, as well as Astra.
Yeah.
I'm thinking that they're going to be doubling on the defensive end. They're going to be double teaming like they did. That helped them against Marino.
Right.
Helped to bring them back into the game. So.
Yeah, I know Caitlin Walkie had two key ones too. So that, you know, she's also an issue. But
true.
Like time is there's only 2 minutes left in the game and they're trailing by 9. Some great, you know, we talked about stuff coming off the bench for Kamehameha.
Oops.
Tori Jean Camera did a great job. We can't have those things happening.
Right. I mean, not worth those 2 seconds or so.
Yeah. Kalpono Faye going in. Now we got two big bigs and 3 perimeters. See what coach has figured it out. Picking up a straight man. Astra goes by her, goes to the basket, gets fouled. That's one way of doing it, scoring without the clock moving. But in the same sense, they're just matching. The contribution of Tori Jean Camera hitting those 2 free throws. I mean, that's the things that we talked about at halftime, where Coach Yamanaka had to find somebody from his bench to spark their team. Astra Kidani, first shot of a 2-shot, she misses. And they are going offense, defense. As they take Tyra out, maybe Sam can do a better job watching Lilia and maybe Kiao on Alohi. We'll see. Second shot by Astra, she hits it. See what Puno's in. It looked like they're in a straight man with maybe a double, depending. They're trying to find Kanoa. Oh, they double her, which is smart to do. Got her from behind, but she picks it up, pivots. Now straight man, spreading them. And there's the mismatch. Well, that was a good timeout for Puno. I thought
that
Robbins
helped.
had Kiao a step looking going to the basket. And
right. That was a layup.
Coach Darrell, I maybe didn't want that, but I think that was maybe ill-advised, but you know, better safe than sorry.
Right, they just want to run the clock. Maybe he just wants him to pass it out, keep the clock rolling. Don't need to take some of those shots and give the ball back to put it home.
You hear the alumni band in the back. We talked about how they bring spirit to the game. We got alumni and their families over there. Great Kim and is the leader of that band, and a lot of alumni involved and their spirit. School appreciates it, and you know, it's good for the girls' game and then also the boys' game coming up.
It's a great atmosphere when you have a band playing at your game. gets the kids excited, and it's just a fun atmosphere. It's a good place to be on a Saturday afternoon, Saturday evening.
Well, if you're watching this, wherever you are, it's good to be watching this basketball game. This is a pretty competitive game, even though Kamehameha is up by 8. Puno's been scrapping and fighting, and that's all you expect from them. We'll see what happens here. It's going to be a pick and roll back. Trying to open up. Kanoa with the ball. Ashton's going to got to get on her. Stabs at the ball. Kicks it out. Kamehameha's just going to work clock. They're doubling. And they're going to have to foul. And they do. That takes Puno to 6 fouls. They have to foul once more. And if you're going to use that strategy, hopefully you foul fast.
Right.
Puno has to be aware because they might get something quick going through this basket. Asher with the steal on Morocco with the steal on that on Kanoa. To get it down, inside out. Turn it to the basket. A little bit short. Over the top. Robin saves it athletically in bounds. Oh, ball turned over. Kanoa with the ball again. Foul by Motooka. Now it's a 3-point. Now it's a three, you know, it's a free throw shooting contest. And this is what you practice.
Right. A hard work by Motooka. I know she was a little frustrated with that play, but working hard and stopped the play.
Nice shot by Kia Kanoa. Second shot. Just rims out. Still up by 9.
Puno
needs something quick in a timeout. High pick and roll inside to Sam Alakai. Struggling with the ball. Jump ball. It's Puno's ball.
They've got your 3-point shooter in Astra waiting for the ball out there. I think they're going to need a few of those along the way.
Well, 42 seconds left. We'll see what Puno can do. Here it comes. Double screen down for Astra. Doesn't get Robbins right on her. They did a pick and roll. The thought was there. Execution wasn't. But good try. Now Puno has to foul. And they're down by 9. So 35 seconds. Robbins with the ball. Taking it out of court. Morocco trying to get her. And she finds Kanoa, a steady person. So Kanoa is at the free throw line for 2, trying to seal it. And she hits it. You know, like if you have a really good point guard, you know, that's a luxury, and for her transferring into commitment, that's even more of a luxury. Kel Puno with another rebound. Puno has to run. I mean, they're down 10. Pushing the ball up. Dribbling. Corner. 3. In and out. Robbins with the rebound. To Kanoa. To Robbins. Over the top. Nueku. Layup. And that layup doesn't really affect the game, but it's 50-38. Well played by both teams, and Kamehameha up by 12. We're gonna have an interview with Alohi Robbins Hardy and Tia Kanoa. Two keys to the game. We got the inside and the outside, and they worked really well together, and it came into a. Resulted in a 12-point Kamehameha win. You know, the score doesn't really is not indicative of how well that both teams played. The game was a lot closer, but I think Kamehameha really controlled the game in the third quarter and really solidified their dominance in the fourth. And we're going to have the interview with those two girls who are who key Kamehameha's win in a bit. But coming up is going to be the boys, varsity, Puno versus Kamehameha varsity boys basketball, and it'll be called by Coach Byron Mello and Coach Chris Diaz. As we try to get the girls up here, maybe they can come up. I'm not sure. Maybe Coach wants to talk to them. But well played game by both. This you know, I think solidifies Kamehameha girls in their league, as they haven't lost yet, and the team trailing them have multiple losses. So it almost gets to a point where they'll be mathematically number one. And for Puno, they're probably playing for seeding in that tournament, or just getting better. Yeah. Well, we have two players, and you know, you guys did such a good job sharing on the court, so you got to share this mic, okay? Okay. Alohi, we talked about last year, I called some of your games, and you played the perimeter a lot. And now with your buddy from the mainland coming in, now you get to show your whole game. Now you get to go inside, outside game. How does that affect your team this year?
Well, it helps a lot. We have about equal amount of posts and guards. So, you know, sometimes I get to play guard, but most of the time I'm post, and then she's point. So.
Well, for you, Tia, how does it feel to have a post who you can outlet to, and now she can take the break, and I saw in the game, you're a key out there. She's always finding you on the outlet, and you're bringing the ball up, and she's rim running too. So it's a dual team, and it's you know, like in this game, it showed that you guys were working well together.
Yeah, it really helps to have her, because I can always count on her on both sides of the board. And she always looks for me right after, so we can get a quick fast break and go into our secondary. And that really just helps us to have a fast-paced offense, and that really pushes us. It's really helpful. And also to have her to be able to bring the ball up relieves me if I have somebody, me or my other teammates, when we have somebody who's really pressuring us.
Good.
So that really helps a lot.
Any comparison to your team last year?
Last year we had Maya and Melina, the two twins that right now are at USD, and we had them in the same way. They were always rebounding for us, and it was a quick outlet, and we went. And that's how we ran our offense, and that's what really helped us to become champions. And that's why I really love having Alohi on my team, because I can count on her. It's the same kind of a tempo. That's what I love it.
You got a nice transition to be able to have these teammates on your team this year.
Definitely, definitely.
And even late in the game, both you guys hit some really key free throws just to solidify the game. Now, what do you think your mindset is now that you have lengthened your lead over all the teams who have kind of been beating each other? Now you have a couple game lead. What do you think your mindset is going to be going forward?
Well, we just have to keep working hard in practice and come out in games, show what we have, and work as a team.
Okay.
Anything else, Tia?
Well,
you want to say hi to anybody on the mainland?
Maybe they're up there watching you online.
All my teammates, I love you guys. I miss you guys. Yeah.
All righty.
Thanks.
Thank you very much. Good luck in you guys' season.
Congratulations.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, there we have it. You know, two faces that you probably want to watch during the ILH and probably in the maybe state tournament run. But you know, great game, and you know, hats off to Puno too. You know, they tried their best, they brought it, they showed something different, tried to change their game to battle that mismatch with those two girls. But you know, if those two girls are at their top of the game, it's gonna be really hard, Coach.
They're definitely going to be representing the ILH very well in the state tournament. I think they've got a good cast of players too, and it was it's always nice when you've got a lot of players playing. It wasn't just a set seven or six players, but it was a shared effort. And in talking to Coach Darrell, you know, he talked about how close this team is, how well they're everyone has blended and has bought into the system that they've brought to the program. It's their second year
right.
as a coaching staff, so it's kind of a nice thing to see when your team is becoming successful and everybody is feeling good about the successes also.
I think for Puno, I think they got to get back into the gym. I think they did a great job. You know, their improvement showed tonight, but you can't really see how much you got further when you're playing the number one team in the state, right? So
right.
They got to keep on getting better, and they have. And you know, like shoot for the, you know, get better in these last couple games, and when they get into that tourney, you know, show what they can do. Because like I said, other than Kamehameha, you know, between Marino, Iolani, and Puno, you know, there's some representatives in there. So it's key that Puno doesn't just forget about this loss. They have to learn from this loss and get better from it.
They've got to feel good about the adjustments that they've made and the success they had, especially in the first three quarters. And they know that they still have an opportunity to compete for that slot in the state, for the state tournament. And so, you know, they've got lots to work up to and lots to be proud of and lots to look forward to in the next couple of games.
Okay, we're looking forward to this upcoming boys game with Puno versus Kamehameha, called by Chris Diaz and Byron Mello. But for Shelly Fay, I'm Alan Lum, and we're signing off right now. And aloha, and have a good night.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks, Alan.
All righty.
Okay, aloha.